Busy mums, we are always looking for ways to stretch the hours in the day. This morning we've got a few ideas to help make your life easier. And to help us do that, we have the wonderful Anna Taylor. Hello. Hello. Lovely to see you, gorgeous girl.
You too, my
now,
friend.
Tell me, tomatoes.
I know. Now,
good way to cut them.
Yeah, well, there's a fantastic way to cut them. Miguel, I don't know if you've ever done this before. If you're at home, okay, mum's always trying to save time in the kitchen.
You've got a bazillion things on
your
mind.
You're making your salad. Put your cherry tomatoes on the plate.
Yes.
A few more, Jess.
Come on. What kind of salad is this?
Now, I call this the ninja tomato trick.
Ah.
Okay. Plate on the top.
No, please. Yes, I'll let you do that.
I'll attempt.
Okay, now, put your hand on top of the plate and quickly slice through.
Wow, yeah, that's
great.
You
need to do this at Café Del Mar.
Look at this.
Yeah.
What an artist.
Wow. Oh, yes.
That's an instant tomato salsa.
That's good. But that's a good way of doing it.
But I should have done that for you.
But that's not bad.
I got to say, this is my kind of segment.
You needed to do that, but they do. You can slice them very, very quickly. Now, Casey, our beautiful director, loves making Thai dishes and salads. We all buy spring onions at the supermarket, and what do? We use two, cut two up, chuck the rest in the bottom of the crisper, and they go rotten and they stink.
Mouldy.
So.
Mouldy?
Yeah, they do go mouldy.
What is wrong with your fridge?
Well, you know, but you forget they smell terrible.
6 months later.
Yeah.
So you've cut your two. What do you do with the four left? Casey, our wonderful director, came up with this tip, is to put your spring onions in a little bowl of soil.
Wow.
Like this, and you can keep it on your windowsill, water them. Would you ever do this?
This is taking interior design.
It's such a good idea.
But then are they safe then to still use? You can pull them out and wash them.
You've got them fresh all the time.
And do they grow big?
Yeah, Casey was going to bring his in this morning, and his partner used all of them in cooking last night.
Sarah Harris does this with potatoes all the time. I've seen it, yeah.
That's a great idea.
It's amazing.
Now, jeans, I'm always finding Bricky's bum. I lean over and my jeans.
Plumber's crack?
Yeah, all of that.
Okay,
wow. We keep our jeans up.
Have you ever had that problem?
I put my undies really high,
yeah,
so that doesn't happen.
Often bending down, picking stuff up at the park.
This is a really good one that we found online yesterday. Now, I've got my 12-year-old's jeans, and if his fly ever came down, it'd be, you know, Mum, I'm not wearing these jeans. If you happen to be out and you've got your keys, car keys with you, take the key ring off, stick it
On the zip,
right? So you've got your falling down fly. Zip your pants up.
So, what do you mean? So what about you in a rush? That doesn't work for guys. What about you in a rush and you need to do that wee-wee?
No.
Come on.
That's
like,
a good idea.
Can do it.
And your fly will never calm down. You would do that. You would do it.
Yeah, I like it.
Joe, what do you think? I'm sorry, I need to go to the toilet.
Quickly. Surely having the ring is actually worse than having your fly open, isn't it?
No, don't you think that's a good idea? I think that's a fabulous idea.
I would use that.
Yeah, me too. Now, boots. You've got some boots. I've got lots of stuff that you shove in your cupboard and it'll get squishy and you don't know what's in there.
These are the boots that I wear to rugby on the weekends. Miguel, there's a pool noodle under there.
Noodle. Yeah, here we are.
Okay, could you cut that quickly?
Voila, as you do.
Yes,
you
got the noodle. Cut that.
How big?
Maybe that big.
That big?
Yeah. This is Jono's pool noodle.
Okay.
And if you get your pool noodle...
I didn't realise it was going to be cut.
Fine. Two Jono's.
This is good. This is good.
Oh, another one?
No, two's enough.
Two's enough.
And your will stay up in your cupboard.
I like that very much.
That's a really good idea.
And toasted sandwiches, I feed my girls them a lot.
Yeah, I know. And in the production office upstairs, we all live on them too. A really good idea for a cheese toasty.
Mama, there's a busy one.
You're a bit nervous about this toaster.
I'm extremely nervous.
Okay,
yes.
So the thing that we do need to point out is we never use knives near toasters ever.
Fantastic.
But if you do need to make a cheese toasty at home, children, you're not to do it. This is for mum and dad only. If you're in a rush, you can get your cheese.
Look at
you
that.
You can put it on the bread. Mm. Turn your toaster on its side.
Wow.
Pop it in.
I like this.
And I haven't got it on, but you can put it on.
Yeah, who needs to watch MasterChef with this
coming
down?
Exactly. But that's fantastic.
Wow, look at this.
That's a really handy way. Anna, I love these tips. I hope you're going to bring us some more. very soon. And if you've got any handy hints or tricks that you would like to share with us, please get in touch and we'd love to put them up on the show.
Don't smell my boots.
And
Anna Taylor, what a joy to have you come back again and share some more things with us.
They were fantastic. I'll definitely get some of those at home. We are back after a very short break with two inspirational people who will really make a day.